So now we know that for this parabola, which is y square equals 4ax, equation of normal is y equals mx minus am cube minus 2am. Now suppose we need to find equation of a normal which passes through a point, say alpha comma beta. So that means this normal will pass through this point. So we can write this as beta equals m alpha minus am cube minus 2am. Now we can rearrange this equation and we can express it as a polynomial in terms of m. So we can write this equation as am cube plus 2a minus alpha m and then plus beta equals to 0, which is a cubic equation in m. So that simply means from a point, if we draw a normal to a parabola, so then we get a cubic equation in m. And if we have cubic equation, we have two possibilities. Either it will have one real root or it will have three real roots. So that means from any point, either one normal can be drawn or from a point, three normals can be drawn to a parabola. So there'll be many questions where we'll be using this cubic equation to find relationship between slopes of three normals that can be drawn from a point to a given parabola. So suppose we have this parabola, which is y square equals 4ax, then from certain points, we can draw three normals to this parabola whose slopes are m1, m2 and m3. Let us consider a question where from this point alpha comma beta, three normals can be drawn. So if three normals can be drawn from this point P, alpha comma beta, we know that its cubic equation will be am cube plus 2a minus alpha m and then plus beta equals to 0. And this equation will have three real roots, which are m1, m2 and m3. Now, if we write sum of roots, which is m1 plus m2 plus m3, now in this case, m1 plus m2 plus m3, so there is no m square, so it will be simply 0. So if from a point, three normals are drawn to a parabola, then sum of slopes of these normals should be 0. Now, we can write this result in other terms also. So we know that if we draw a normal to a parabola whose slope is m1, then this foot of normal, so say in this case it is a, so it will be a m1 square twice a m1. This point is say b, which is a m2 square twice a m2, and c, which is a m3 square twice a m3. Then if we'll find the sum of their y coordinates, so y1, y2 and y3, in that case y1 plus y2 plus y3, we'll take 2a common and then it'll be m1 plus m2 plus m3. So we know that m1 plus m2 plus m3 is 0. So from here we'll get this result, which is summation yi equals to 0, which simply means if these three points are foot of normal drawn from a point on a parabola, then sum of their y coordinates, it must be 0. And these three points A, B and C, which is foot of normal drawn from point P, are called as co-normal points. So for co-normal points, y1 plus y2 plus y3 must be 0. And m1 plus m2 plus m3 must also be 0. So this is the condition for co-normal points on a parabola. So co-normal points are those points on parabola at which normals drawn will be concurrent at a point. We draw a normal at A, B and C. All the three normals, they'll intersect at this point P. So these three points A, B and C, they are co-normal points. Now here we need to prove that circle through co-normal points passes through vertex of parabola, and we need to find its equation also. So suppose there's a point P, which is say x1, y1, and from this point, three normals are drawn to the parabola. So we know that equation of normal to parabola is y equals mx minus am cube minus 2am. Now this normal, it passes through this point x1, y1. So we can write this as y1 equals mx1 minus am cube minus 2am. Now we can write this equation as a cubic equation in terms of m. So we can write this am cube and then plus 2a minus x1 into m and plus y1 equals to 0. Since three normals can be drawn, so we know that this equation will have three roots, m1, m2 and m3, and we also know that m1 plus m2 plus m3 is equal to 0. Now we know that if the slopes of normal are m1, m2 and m3, then in that case foot of normal will be given by am square minus 2am1, b am2 square minus 2am2, and c am3 square minus 2am3. Now we need to find equation of a circle which passes through these three co-normal points. So let us take any general equation of circle. So a circle which passes through these three co-normal points, let it be x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy and then plus c equals to 0. Now all these three points, they lie on the circle, and if we write general condition or general coordinates for these three points, we can write it as am square minus 2am. Now we'll put the value of x and y in this equation. We can write this equation as a square m to the power 4 plus 4a square m square plus 2g am square and then minus 4f am and plus c equals to 0. So we can write this as a fourth degree equation in m. So we can write it as a square m to the power 4 plus, now here it will be 4a square plus 2ag m square minus 4f am and then plus c equals to 0. Now this fourth degree equation will have four roots. So say m1, m2, m3 and m4. Now we'll find sum of roots m1 plus m2 plus m3 plus m4. Now there is no m cube here. So that means sum of all the roots is 0. And we know that m1, m2 and m3 are slopes of normals which are drawn from the same point. Then m1 plus m2 plus m3 is 0. So we'll put this as 0. We'll get m4 as 0. If we'll put m4 as 0, then we'll get one of the point from which this circle will pass. So this circle will pass through 0, 0, and which is vertex of this parabola. So that's our first part, that the circle through conormal points passes through vertex. Now we need to find its equation also. So what we'll do is we'll put 0, 0, then we'll get the c as 0. So we'll put c as 0 and then I'll take a common, and also I'll take m common. So if I'll take am common, then I can write this equation as am cube plus 4a plus 2gm minus 4f equals to 0. So we get this cubic equation whose roots are m1, m2 and m3, which again is represented by this equation. So we'll compare these two equations, then simply we can write 2a minus x1 must be equal to 4a plus 2g, and in the same way we can write y1 must be equals to minus 4f. So here we can get the value of g. So value of g here will be minus x1 plus 2a divided by 2, and f will be minus y1 by 4. So now we have g, f, and c. So now we can write equation of this circle. So equation of this circle will be x square plus y square plus 2gx. So it will be minus x1 plus 2ax and then plus 2fy. So which will be minus y1 upon 2, y equals to 0. And that is the equation of circle passing through three co-normal points. Now the question is, normals are drawn from point P with slopes m1, m2 and m3 to parabola y square equals 4x. If locus of P with m1 into m2 equals alpha is a part of parabola itself, then find the value of alpha. We need to find locus of this point P. So suppose we let this point P as some h, k, and for this parabola we'll know value of a is 1. So we can write equation of normal as y equals mx minus am cube minus 2am, a is 1, so it'll be minus 2m. Now this normal, it passes through this point h, k. So it'll be k mh minus m cube minus 2m. So we'll write this equation as m cube plus 2 minus hm and then plus k equals to 0. So which is a cubic equation in m. Now we know that for this equation m1 into m2 into m3, its value is minus b upon a. So it'll simply be minus k. Now it is given that m1 into m2 is alpha. So we'll put m1 into m2 as alpha. We can write m3 as minus k upon alpha. Now m3, it is the root of this equation. So we'll put the value of m3. We can write this as k cube upon alpha cube and then this minus sign and then minus 2 minus h k upon alpha and then plus k equals to 0. So we can take this k common and then we can write this as k square upon alpha cube plus 2 minus h upon alpha and then plus 1 equals to 0. So we can write this equation as k square upon alpha cube and it will be h minus alpha minus 2 upon alpha. So we'll write this equation as k square equals alpha square h minus alpha minus 2. So locus of this point P, it will be y square equals alpha square x minus alpha plus 2. Now in the question it says the locus of this point P is a part of the parabola itself. So that means this locus, it should be y square equals 4x. Now we'll compare, then we'll get two conditions and which are value of alpha square should be 4 and alpha plus 2 should be 0. So from here we get only one condition and that is alpha equals minus 2. So answer to this question is the value of alpha should be minus 2. Now here the question is, normals are drawn from point 4 comma 1 to the parabola y square equals 4x. The tangent at the feet of normal to parabola y square equals to 4x form a triangle ABC. So first we'll find equation of normal. So for this parabola, value of a is 1. So we'll write equation of normal in parametric form. So equation of normal in parametric form will be y plus tx equals at cube and a here is 1 plus 2at. So there'll be simply 2t and we need normals passing through 4 comma 1. So we'll put x as 4 and y as 1. So it'll be 1 plus 4t and this is t cube plus 2t. So it'll be t cube minus 2t minus 1 equals to 0. Now we can add one and subtract one. So we can write this as t cube plus 1. So it will be t plus 1 and then t square minus t plus 1 and then minus 2 and it will be t plus 1. So we can write this as t plus 1 and t square minus t minus 1 equals to 0. So value of t is minus 1, or the value of t is 1 plus minus under root 5 upon 2. So now we have t1, t2 and t3. Suppose t1 is minus 1, t2 is 1 plus under root 5 upon 2 and t3 is 1 minus under root 5 upon 2. Now we know that these point of intersection of tangents is at1, t2 and at1 plus t2. So we'll write these point of intersections as, suppose a is t1, t2. t1, t2 is minus 1 minus root 5 by 2 and then t1 plus t2. So we'll add them. We'll get minus 1 plus under root 5 by 2. Now b will be t2, t3, 1 minus 5 minus 4 upon 4 will be minus 1 and then t1 plus t2. So it'll be minus 1 comma 1. And c will be t1, t3. So it'll be minus 1 plus root 5 upon 2 and then t1 plus t3. So it'll be minus 1 minus under root 5 by 2. Now first we'll find centroid of this triangle. So centroid of this triangle will be, now we'll add the x coordinates. So it'll be root 5 by 2 will cancel. So we'll get minus 1 and then minus 1. So it'll be minus 2 by 3. And its y coordinate, it will be, now root 5 by 2 will cancel, so it will be 0. So distance of focus from centroid, so we know that for this triangle focus is at a comma 0, so it will be at 1 comma 0. So distance of focus from centroid, it will simply be mod of 1 plus 2 by 3, so it will be 5 by 3. So option A, it matches to 5 by 3. Now the second question is distance of focus of this parabola from orthocenter of triangle ABC. Now we look at this T2 and T3, then if we'll multiply T2 into T3, we know that this value will be minus 1. When T2 into T3 is minus 1, so it simply means that these two tangents, they are perpendicular. So this triangle ABC will be a right angle triangle. And point of intersection of T2 and T3 is B, which is minus 1 comma 1. So that means orthocenter of this triangle is at minus 1 comma 1. So distance of focus from orthocenter, so it'll be simply BS and it'll be under root of, now this is 2 square and then plus 1 square. So it'll be simply root 5. So distance of focus from orthocenter of triangle ABC is simply root 5. That's your option number D. Now the third question is distance of focus of parabola from circumcenter of triangle ABC. Now since this triangle ABC, it's a right angle triangle, then its circumcenter is actually midpoint of hypotenuse. So let circumcenter be some C dash. So C dash is midpoint of AC. Now what's A? A is minus 1 minus root 5 by 2 and c is minus 1 plus root 5 by 2. So we'll find its midpoint. So root 5 by 2 will cancel. So it'll be minus 1. So it'll be minus 1 by 2. So again for y coordinate, root 5 by 2 will cancel. So again it'll be minus 1 by 2. So distance of circumcenter from focus will be under root of, now 1 minus 1 by 2 will be 3 by 2. So 3 by 2 square is 9 by 4 plus 1 by 4. So it should be under root of 10 by 4, which is simply root 5 by 2 or under root 10 by 2. And that's your option Q. And now this last one, which is area of triangle ABC. Now area of triangle formed by tangents is given by 1 upon 2 A square. And then it is T1 minus T2. T2 minus T3 and then T3 minus T1, its modulus value. So it will be 1 by 2. Now A in this case is simply 1. Now here T1 is minus 1 t2 is 1 plus root 5 by 2 and t3 is 1 minus under root 5 by 2. Now what's t1 minus t2? t1 minus t2 will be minus 3 minus root 5 by 2 and then t2 minus t3. T2 minus t3 will be simply root 5 and then t3 minus t1. So it'll be 3 minus root 5 by 2 and its absolute value. So it'll be 1 by 8 and then root 5. And this is a plus b, a minus b. So there'll be 9 minus 5. So it should be 4. So its area should be root 5 by 2. So area of triangle ABC is under root 5 by 2. And that's your option S. So this is how we can solve this question.